another video of our today's session. In today's session, we are going with our chapter number 5. One kind of you can say like the revisions, or you can say like the question answerings. Okay, so if you have any doubts, so I think you will get the clear all of your doubt in this video. Okay, so as we know, we have already complete our unit number 5, and I know that hope you haven't any doubt about this unit, but still if you have any doubt, so make sure you are going to watch this video very carefully, and hence hope you will get all your doubts clear. So let's start with our unit number 5, that is the fundamental unit of our life. So what is the fundamental unit of our life? So as we know, the cell, that is the fundamental unit of our life. That the fundamental, that means the cell, that is nothing but the functional and the structural unit of our life. That means if there is no cell, there is no any kind of the living or non-living organisms are to be there. Okay, so cell is what? The cell is a functional and a structural unit of our life. If there is no cell, then if we have a structure of our body, suppose without the cell, but we can't able to function, our body can't able to function any kind of the our body can't able to make any kind of the functions. Or if we can able to make any functions, but if there is no cell, there is no any structure of our body. So cell is the most necessary, because if there is a cell, that and then only that is the we can able to do any kind of the function. And before we going to do function, we have the structure. Okay, so cell is nothing but it is the functional and the structural unit of our life. So there are the two type of the cells, as we know, that is the prokaryotic cell and another one, that is the eukaryotic cell. Okay, so what is the difference, major or main difference between this prokaryotic cell and this eukaryotic cell? So as we know, the structural organizations of the cell, so here is the cell, and suppose it is the cell, so in the center there is the nucleus. Okay, so that nucleus, that is surrounded by that some space, and that space, that is known as the cytoplasm, and that the outermost area, that is known as the cell membrane, or we can say that the plasma membrane. So in the center, that is known as the nucleus. Okay, so the prokaryotic cell and that the eukaryotic cell, they are differentiated by this nucleus. How? So suppose we are going to talk about the prokaryotic cell. So we can say that in the prokaryotic cell, there is a not well defined, or we can say that it can't contain the well defined nucleus. So what I'm going to say about the not well defined nucleus, that means we can say that in the prokaryotic cell, that nucleus, it couldn't bounded by the nuclear membrane, or we can say that there is the absence of the nuclear membrane. So there is absence of the nuclear membrane, and due to that absence of the nuclear membrane, that nucleus in the prokaryotic cell, that is known as the nucleus. Okay, and while if you are going to talk about the eukaryotic cell, so we can say that in the eukaryotic cell, that eukaryotic cell has the well-defined nuclear membrane, or we can say that it is the it has the well-defined nucleus, and hence that is known as the eukaryotic cell. That means if there is a nucleus, and that nucleus, that is covered by that membrane, and we can say that that membrane, that is known as the plasma membrane. Okay. Now, if you are talking about the inside the nucleus, so what is there inside the nucleus in prokaryotic cell and in the eukaryotic cell? So as we can see that in our previous video, we can see that in the prokaryotic cell, that it contains only one chromosome, while as the eukaryotic cell, it contains more than one or two chromosomes. Okay, so that is the major difference between the eukaryotic cell and prokaryotic cell. Okay, then we have talked about the structural organizations of the cell, that is, there are the three three layer of the cell. There's the first layer that is known as the cell membrane. After the cell membrane, there is the cytoplasm, and in the center there is the nucleus. And we have already observed in our first video that the onion cell, and then after in the second video we have talked about the chick cell. So as you can see, in the chick cell the nucleus which have the different shapes, like the spherical shape, ovum like say shape. Then after we can observe in that particular pictures about the chick cell, we can say that it has the egg like structure. So we can say that the shape and the size of the cells differ, or we can say that varies with the another different animal or the different parts of our body. As we can say that there is the if we are going to take the some cell from here, that is at the cell, and at the another cell, that is the that cell that is our nerve cell. Or then after we can say that about the sperm, that all the cells are the different in their shape, or we can say that in their functions. Okay, that all the cells are different, but what is the major similarities in all kind of the cell, if we are going to talking about the plant cell or if we are going to talking about the animal cell? So there is the only one similarities, and that one similarities, that is what? That is the cell organelles. That both the cell, that is the animal cell, or if we are going to talk about the plant cell, that the both the cell, they contain one similar thing, and that is the cell organelles. So what is the cell organelles? That the average cells contain some small structure which have some specific functions, and that small structure having some specific function, that is known as the cell organelles. So let me talk about the some cell organelles. But before we going ahead with the our cell organelles, we let us see about the some special cases in the cell membrane, that is the diffusion and osmosis. So what is the diffusion? That is the flow of the some gases across the plasma membrane via semi-permeable membrane, and that phenomenon, that is the gases like carbon dioxide, and oxygen, that can able to go inside or outside of that nucleus, and that process, that phenomenon, that is known as the diffusion. So what is the diffusion? We can say that the flow of the any gases from its high concentration to lower concentration, and that flow, that is known as the diffusion. So we are going to talking about the osmosis. Then what is the osmosis? So we can say that the osmosis is the nothing, but it is the special case of the diffusion, or we can say that it is the totally inversely than that of the diffusion. In the diffusion we have talked about, that is the flow of the from its higher concentration to its lower concentration, while in the osmosis, that is the flow of the water from its lower concentration to its higher concentration. Why that water go into the higher concentration instead of going from higher concentration to lower concentration? Because that at the higher concentration there is the less water, and in the lower concentration there is the high water. In the another terms, we can say that the higher concentration, that means the concentrated solution which having the more solute and less water, while is the lower concentration, that means we can say that it is the diluted solution, that means there is a very less solute and there is the much more water than that of the concentrated solution. So we can say that the concentration of the water is higher in that dilute solution, while the concentration of the water is lower in that concentrated solution. So there is a net flow of the water from this lower concentration to higher concentration. Okay, for what is the reason behind that? Why it is going to that particular in higher concentration? Because for the dilution. That means this process will continue till there is the equilibrium is established. ठीक है, मतलब कि जब तक वहां पर इक्विलिब्रियम एस्टैब्लिश नहीं होता तब तक के लिए ये फ्लो चलता रहेगा. एंड देन आफ्टर वी हैव टॉकिंग अबाउट द थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ द सॉल्यूशन. फर्स्ट वन, दैट इज द हाइपोटोनिक सॉल्यूशन. देन आफ्टर वी हैव टॉकिंग अबाउट द आइसोटोनिक सॉल्यूशन, एंड देन आफ्टर वी हैव टॉकिंग अबाउट द हाइपोटोनिक सॉल्यूशन. सो व्हाट हैपेंड व्हेनेवर आई एम गोइंग टू पुट दैट सेल इनटू द हाइपोटोनिक सॉल्यूशन. सो व्हेनेवर आई एम गोइंग टू पुट सेल इनटू द हाइपोटोनिक सॉल्यूशन, द सेल विल स्वेल अप. because of the higher concentration of the cell, while as a lower concentration of the medium, and hence the water is come inside the cell via semi-permeable membrane, that is the SPM. What happened in the isotonic solution, whenever I am going to put that cell into the isotonic solution? So in the isotonic solution, there is no net change of the water, because the concentration of the cell while the concentration of the medium is the same, and due to the same concentration, there is no net flow of the water inside or the outside of the cell, and hence there is no net change observed in the cell. So that's about the isotonic solution. And what happened when I am going to put the cell into the hypertonic solution? So whenever I am going to put that cell into the hypertonic solution, the concentration of the medium is higher than that of the cell, and due to that is the reason the cell will be the shrink up. So that's it all about the our osmosis and diffusion. Now we have talking about the some cell organelles. That is the first cell organelles, that is the our endoplasmic reticulum. Okay, so in the endoplasmic reticulum, we have talked it has two types of the endoplasmic reticulum. Okay, let me recall you about the cell wall. So we can say that the cell wall, that is the only and only present in the plant cell. Okay, so if there is a cell membrane, or we can say the plasma membrane, that plasma membrane is covered by some another membrane, or we can say that the plasma membrane is bounded by the another membrane, and that membrane that is known as the cell wall, but it can be able to only and only into the plant cell. Okay, so that is it about the cell wall. And in the cell wall, we have talking about the plasmolysis. So what is the plasmolysis? So whenever the cell is put up into the hypertonic solution, so what happened? Whenever we are going to put that cell into the hypertonic solution, the cell will be the shrink up. So we can say that the cell will be going to be shrink up, but the cell wall is remaining there, and that cell membrane is go away, or we can say that go away inside the cell. That means this type of the condition, and that type of the phenomenon that is known as the plasmolysis. Thereafter, we have talked about the plasmolysis in the rheolip. So what happened? We are going to take the rheolip and observe this practical. So we have observed in that practical, we have taken the two types of the lip, that is a rheolip, and the another one is also rheolip, but it is the boil in the water. So whenever we are going to boil that rheolip into the water, we can say that the all the cell that is present in that rheolip are going to be die, and hence this is the reason in the die in that boiled rheolips, whenever we are going to observe that rheolip into the microscopic observation, we can say that there is no kind of the any change, because we can say that only living cell that can able to undergoes this plasmolysis. So that is all about the our structural organization. Then we are talking about the some cell organelles. There is the first one, that is the endoplasmic reticulum. So in the endoplasmic reticulum, we have said that the endoplasmic reticulum, that is also known as the transportation chain or the channel, transport channel. Okay, why it is known as the transport channel? Because it is undergoes some chemical process or some chemical reaction. It is going to be produce some lipids and that protein, and that lipid and that protein which is useful in the membrane biogenesis, and the remaining proteins and the lipids are converted into the enzymes and the hormones. Then after, they are going to be sent to the another parts of the our cells and of the our body. So that is the reason that is known as the channel, transportation channel. Okay, so let me talk about the endoplasmic reticulum. It has a two type, that is the rough endoplasmic reticulum, smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Rough endoplasmic plasmic reticulum, that is known as the rough endoplasmic reticulum, because it contains the dot like structure on the surface, and hence this is the reason it is known as the rough endoplasmic reticulum. Okay, but that dot like structure on that surface of the rough endoplasmic reticulum, and that dot like structure, that is known as the ribosomes. So the ribosomes is the only one thing which is present in the both the cell, as well as the eukaryotic cell, or we can say that into the prokaryotic cell. Okay, so ribosomes, the function of the ribosome is to synthesize the protein. Okay, or we can say that the ribosomes is the useful in the production or in the manufacturing of the protein. So ribosomes is the responsible for the manufacturing of the protein. While whenever we are talking about the smooth endoplasmic reticulum, that the smooth endoplasmic reticulum, that is the responsible for the formations, or the we can say that the production of the lipid. So that lipid that is produced into the smooth endoplasmic reticulum and that protein that is produced into the rough endoplasmic reticulum, that both are used into the building of the cell membrane, or we can say the plasma membrane, and that process that the protein and the lipids of the endoplasmic reticulum are used in the building of the cell membrane or the plasma membrane, and that process that is known as the membrane biogenesis. So some other lipids and the proteins that are not used in the membrane biogenesis are the converted into the enzymes and the hormones, and that enzymes and the hormones are very useful in our bodies and our biochemical activities. Thereafter, we are going to talking about the Golgi apparatus. The Golgi apparatus is nothing but it is known as the packaging unit of our cell. So as we discussed that the our cell is nothing but it is its function like similarly that the factory outlet. Okay, so we have compared the cell with the factory in our previous video. That is it may be in the video number 4. So you can go through it. So if you don't know anything about that, okay. So in the factory, we know that there is the assembling, then after the manufacturing, then after the packaging, and then after the transportations of the materials. Okay. So similarly, in the cell, there is also that that kind of the thing. The endoplasmic reticulum is nothing but it is a manufacturing plants of the lipid, protein, or enzymes or hormones. Then after, what happened? That particular materials that into the endoplasmic reticulum are packed or are transferred from the endoplasmic reticulum to the Golgi apparatus via vesicles. So that materials are filled up in the vesicles and then it will be transferred into the Golgi apparatus, and that Golgi apparatus, the function of this Golgi apparatus is to collect that material and store it into the it. Then after, if there is the necessity or it is the essential, then after it is going to be the under modifications. Then after the modification, it will be packed. Okay, मतलब कि उसका क्या होगा? Packaging होगा. And जैसे भी packaging होगा, it will be sent to its targeted unit. मतलब कि उसको अभी उसको target किए वाले unit पर वहाँ पर उसको send कर दिया जाएगा. So that is the functions of this Golgi apparatus. Then the most important function of that Golgi apparatus, that is the Golgi apparatus, it is most useful in the manufacturing or in the formations of the lysosomes. Not the manufacturing, but it is useful in the formation of the lysosome. So what is the lysosome? So lysosomes is nothing but it is the cleanliness of our cell, or we can say that it is known as the suicide bag of our cell. So why it is known as the cleanliness of our cell? Because that lysosomes, it is a bowel like structure and they contain so many enzymes in it, and that all the enzymes are very powerful because they can able to digest any kind of the organic material, and hence we can say that enzymes is very powerful. So it can able to digest any kind of the material into the cell. So whenever the cell produce some waste, and whenever that cell is produce some waste, the lysosome is suddenly activated and go toward that waste, and they are going to digest that waste. So we can say that by the means of that, the lysosome is going to be the keep our cell clean, and hence that is the reason that the lysosome, that is known as the cleanliness of our cell. In the some cases, some of the another organelles that are come inside our cell due to some of the reason, or we can say that the another organelles that are going to be the weak. So we can say that is going to be the inactive, and that kind of the case that the foreign material or the some of the inactive organelles, they are also going under the process of the digestion by these lysosomes, and due to that digestion, that our cell going to be the clean, and that is the reason, second reason that the our lysosomes, that is known as the cleanliness of our cell. So why they are known as the suicide bags of our cell? They are known as a suicide bag because in some abnormal conditions, or we can say that there is some damage of the cell. Suppose there is a damage in the cell, and suddenly the cell is going to the perform like the abnormally, and due to in that kind of the situation, that lysosome is going to be the activate, and suddenly they are going to be the burst up, and due to the bursting of that lysosomes, all the enzyme that is the present in that lysosomes are sprayed over the cell, and whenever that enzyme that sprayed over the cell, that enzyme is going to be the digest that on cell, and because of the reason that the lysosomes is the one kind of the agent that going to be the kill their on cell, or we can say that they're going to be the digest their on cell, and that is the reason that the lysosome that is known as the suicide back of the cell. Then after we have talk about the mitochondria. The mitochondria, that is nothing, that is known as the powerhouse of our body. Why it is known as the powerhouse of our body? Because the cell needs some energy to perform that chemical activities for the manufacturing or the packaging or for the transportations or anything else, but it needs some energy. Okay, so that energy, or we can say that it needs some energy for some biochemical activity, and that energy that is needed for that some kind of biochemical activity that is provided to that cell in the form of the ATP by mitochondria, and hence that is the reason that the mitochondria that is known as the powerhouse of our body. Or what is the ATP stand for? That the ATP stand for adenosine triphosphate. Okay, so mitochondria, that is the double membrane structure, and the outer membrane, that is the porous, while as the inner membrane, that is the deeply folded inside. Okay, it has their own ribosomes and it can be able to produce their own DNA, and hence that is another reason that is it is known as the powerhouse of our cell. So then after the mitochondria, we are talking about the plastids and the vacuoles. Okay, so plastid is nothing, but it is known as the color pigment, and that is the present in the every kind of the plant, or we can say that the plastid is the only present into the plant cell. Okay, so that is the third difference between the plant cell and the animal cell. Okay, so that is in the previous we are talking about the cell wall, that the cell wall is present into the plant cell only, while is the animal cell, there is the absence of the cell wall. Why we are going to talking about the plastid, that the plastid is also present only into the plant cell, while is the animal cell, there is the absence of the plastid. So we have observed many kind of the plant with the different colors of the leaf, with the different colors of the flower, with the different colors of the fruit, that can able to attract us, or we are going to attract toward them, and because of their different colors, and that colors is come from this plastid. The plastid contain the color bands, or we can say that the color pigment, and according to that color pigment and according to that different color, that is broadly classified into the three categories. The first category is that is known as the chloroplast, second one that is the chromoplast, and the last one that is the leucoplast. And now the chloroplast, the chloroplast contain the chlorophyll, that is the green in the color, and we can say that due to that is the reason that contain the chlorophyll, we can say that it is responsible for the green color in the leaf. Okay, so that chlorophyll that is also useful in the photosynthesis. So what is the photosynthesis? Photosynthesis is nothing but in the presence of the sunlight, this chlorophyll are used in the productions of the food of the that plant, or we can say that in the plants the food production in the presence of the sunlight, and that process that is known as the photosynthesis. Then after we are going we are talking about the chromoplast, that the chromoplast is a different color pigment, and it is present into the flowers and fruits. Okay, so that is the responsible for the different colors of the flower and the fruit. Then after we are talking about the leukocyte, so leukoplast. So that leukoplast, that is a white color, or we can say that the color colorless pigment. Okay, so it is also used, it is a useful, or we can say that the main feature of the leukoplast, that is to store it some sugars, starch, etc. So that is the storage agent of the our cell. So that is all about the plastids. Then after we are talking about the vacuoles. So vacuoles are nothing present in the both the cell, the animal cell, in the plant cell. But in the plant cell, the size of the vacuole is higher. It is much more than that of the animal cell. Or we can say that in the plant cell, there is only one vacuole present, but it occupies the 50 to 90% of the space of that plant cell. While is the animal cell, there is more than 1, 2, 3 or 4 vacuoles having the smaller size. So vacuole is nothing but it is known as the it is useful in the storage of the some material, storage of the food. Okay, so like in amoeba, the vacuoles is useful as the it is known as a food vacuole, that the it is storage some food that is occupied or that is taken by that amoeba. So that is all about the our cell organelles. And then after we have talking about this cell division. So what is the cell division? So cell division is a two type of the cell division. that is the mitosis and the meiosis. Mitosis is responsible for the growth, while as the meiosis that is responsible for the some of the replacement of the dead cell or the inactive cell. Okay, so in the mitosis we have seen that the mother cell under the division, it can be converted into the two daughter cell. But what is the similarity into the mother cell and the daughter cell? There is the chromosome. The number of the chromosome into the mother cell remaining the same into that daughter cell. While in the meiosis, there is a two consecutively division take place, and due to that is the reason in the mother cell, if there is a four cell, in the daughter cell, the half of that the mother cell. So that's it about our chapter number 5, and that is the fundamental unit of our life. So hope you will like our video, and thank you very much for joining this video. Hope you haven't any kind of the doubt, so go through your every worksheet and make it clear that you are going to read very carefully. So thank you very much.